Okay, so if you want to compute the inverse of a 2x2 matrix, one thing you could do is remember the formula. And what's the formula? The formula is swap these two entries, alpha 1, 1, alpha 0, 0, and then negate these two entries, minus alpha 1, 0, and minus alpha 0, 1. And then you need to multiply that by this times that, minus this times that. And in the homework you were asked to verify this, and the way you verify this is you simply multiply this matrix times that matrix and you find out that you end up with the identity. Well, in this case you would find out it's not the identity because this should have been a zero, right? Anyway, the key here is that this quantity right here tells you whether this formula yields a matrix that is the inverse. Okay? If this is non-zero, if this is not zero, then we know that we have a formula for the inverse. And if it is equal to zero, then we don't. So this right here then is called the determinant of this matrix A, where this matrix A is this little 2x2. Okay? Now, how can we use this to find the eigenvalues of a 2x2 matrix? Well, we know that we want to look at the determinant of lambda I minus A. And that determinant, well, if we start with a matrix alpha 0, 0, alpha 0, 1, alpha 1, 0, alpha 1, 1, then this matrix here is the matrix lambda minus that, minus that, minus that, and lambda minus that. Right? And then if we apply the formula for the determinant but to this matrix, what we get is lambda minus alpha 0, 0 times lambda minus alpha 1, 1, that's this times that, minus this times that, minus alpha 1, 0 times alpha 0, 1, because these two minus signs cancel each other. All right, and then we know that that determinant is equal to zero, so we can multiply all of this out and then use whatever method you prefer to compute the roots of a second degree polynomial to find the roots, and those roots then are the eigenvalues of matrix A, and only those roots are the eigenvalues of matrix A. So what we notice now is that there's this relationship between the spectrum of matrix A and the roots of the determinant of this matrix, and this right here, which turns out to be this polynomial right here, is called the characteristic polynomial.